ways you can enhance any screencast. Let's focus on two more, transitions and animations. Transitions are an important part of the video editing process, and when done correctly, can enhance the quality and effectiveness of your screen recording. A transition, in terms of the video editing, is when an effect is applied to connect two separate clips, like this. Transitions are an easy way to move between two different scenes and can help indicate to the viewer that the time or context has changed. When added with purpose, they can help connect your clips in a meaningful way that also looks good. Transitions should usually be added towards the end of the video editing. Adding transitions too early can cause extra work if the position of the clips change or different assets need to be brought together. As you start editing, you'll notice that most video programs have numerous transitions that you can add to your video. We'll talk about a couple of particularly useful ones, but before we do, you should be wary of using too many different types of transitions, as this can distract your viewers. Here are some of the best practices for applying any transition. The most important, which is, transitions need to have a purpose. As with everything done in the video editing process, every decision should be made with the audience and goal in mind. Sometimes, this means that the best transition is no transition, and a basic cut will do. When you're considering using a transition, the types you want to focus on using most are fade or dip to black or white. As you add transitions to your video, they'll work differently across video editing software. Being aware of your software's options may open up creative opportunities to use a transition to achieve the perfect effect to complete your video. As you apply transitions, you'll want to think about the length of the transition. There's not one set answer. Usually, 1 second is the default, but you may need or want it to go faster or slower. The best transitions will not distract the viewer, but will help them clearly follow along with your video. Another type of enhancement, and the last visual enhancement we'll talk about in this series, is animations. Animations are, generally speaking, causing anything in your video to move. This could include having text fly in or appear on screen, having an arrow move from one location to another, having a graphic spin or rotate. Animation is a powerful way to grab your viewers' attention as they watch your video. Because it's an effect that can make an impact, it's definitely worth experimenting with to learn how it impacts the effectiveness of your videos. However, too much of a good thing, especially animations in a screencast, can leave your viewers overwhelmed and frustrated. Regardless of the types of animations you consider adding, ask yourself these questions to make sure it's worth the effort and will have the impact you want. First, will the animation provide clarity or make what you're showing more understandable? Second, will the animation draw attention to an element or aspect of your video that is important or critical without taking away from what you're drawing your viewers' attention to? Third, is the amount of effort required to add the animation worth the outcome? If you're answered no to one of these questions, you may want to skip using an animation. However, if the answer was yes, you'll need to balance out the need and purpose and determine what type of animation will best suit your needs. Even if you're not an expert with animation, using simple animation approaches can add a bit of flair to your screencast and help engage your viewer to help them pay more attention to your message. Whether you're adding transitions or animations, remember, keep them simple and use them with purpose. It's almost time to render and get your video ready to share. Before we do that, we'll take one last look at making sure your audio is ready to go.